हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू डॉक्टर कंसेस वेलनेस सेंटर। एज वी आर इन द सेकंड लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ नोइंग व्हाट डायबिटीज एग्जैक्टली इज। सो दिस इज अबाउट द कंप्लेंट्स ऑफ अ पेशेंट हु इज लाइकली टू हैव डायबिटीज। इन शॉर्ट, व्हाट इज द प्रेजेंटिंग कंप्लेंट फॉर द कंप्लेंट फॉर विच द पेशेंट शुड अटेंड और शुड बी इन्वेस्टिगेटेड बाय द अटेंडिंग फिजिशियन। लेट मी टेल यू, नाउ इट इज माई ओन ऑब्जर्वेशन दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम patient comes without a complaint. It means he is diagnosed, usually diagnosed on routine test. There are many companies who, as a part of their HR policy, give them a package to their employees that they can do once in a year or twice a year some sort of a thing, laboratory test. And many a patients without any symptoms, the diagnosis comes as an accident or a major impact, and they are diagnosed to have diabetes. So the commonest presentation in my personal clinic is that they do not have any complaints, and most of the time it is diagnosed on a routine test. Then obviously there is a classical patient what we describe in the history and in the medical school also, that is the patient has got more hunger, there is more urination, there is more thirst, the patient is fatigued and make complaints of generalized aches and pains. This is absolutely common if the diabetes is usually of longer duration and if the sugar values are very high, then you see this polydipsia, polyuria, and polyphagia and all those things. But that's less common in earlier stage. Then there may be a weight gain or a weight loss. See, if at all patient is in a younger age and starts gaining weight, at a particular weight patient may found to have diabetes. Initially you do a test in obese person, maybe initial visit you do the HbA1c or the sugar fasting and post meal, but the sugar may be values may be normal, but the weight may be increasing, and maybe after then patient goes with the understanding that he hasn't got diabetes. And then maybe a year or two later, maybe another 10-15 kgs, he may have all the laboratory picture of diabetes. Secondly, if the patient is at the peak of his insulin levels and if the insulin level drops, the patient may occasionally have got may come with to you for a weight loss, and then you need to investigate the patient, and the patient may or may not have diabetes. Then the next common entity with the patient of diabetes is either a fatigue. Patient is fatigue all the time, and since he is fatigued, since he cannot make up with his daily routine, he is irritable, and because of that he is depression. So fatigue, irritability and depression, this is a common triad. Obviously the sugar impacts or the sexual potency of the person, especially the male, and so also the female. So the importance, if it is very severe, then you get all these microvascular complications called as, because it affects the smaller and larger blood vessels. So the visual complaints are very common. And if patient of diabetes comes to you many a times undiagnosed, or may come with a complication, and the complication may be related to the heart, brain, kidney, eyes, nose and skin and all other things, and the complaints will vary accordingly. That's what I'm saying. And then if the fasting and post meal glucose levels are normal, that's what I said to you earlier also in the last video also, even in spite of this, you go for HbA1c. That is a better indicator whether to tell definitely whether the patient is diabetic or not. Thank you.